word, Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Every single one of us.
But even in the natural order, how are we using that? How are we observing it? How are we handling it so it brings us higher to realize that everything that we have comes from God? So everything that we are, everything that we have, needs to go back to Him. It is our Lord. Everything. Does that overwhelm you? If it overwhelms me, not just the part, not just the aspect of ourselves that we want to give to Him, that we can give to Him, that it's lovable enough to give to Him, everything has to go back to God. How good are we at doing that? Ask yourself that question. Pray about that question. From the depths of your soul, how good are we at doing that? At discerning and evaluating how I'm living in this world. And how my living in this world is helping me move toward eternal. How is my soul being purified? How am I cooperating with God's grace to cultivate virtue in my life? Virtue is nothing other than a good habit. A vice, a bad habit. So how do we get out of the vices and work on the virtues? Growing in virtue, growing in holiness, growing in sanctity, desiring, having that deep, profound desire to be a saint, and be in that life of heavenly glory here on earth in union with Him. Our soul, in union with Him. We pray maybe some mystical union with Him. Begin here. It's possible and it's doable. How? How do we give everything back to God? Ask yourself. Perhaps we start very fundamentally, just this way. Five things that we can think about, that we can have in mind in giving everything back to God and in cultivating worship. Very simply, five senses. Sight. So many things in the world, so many things in our culture competing for our worship. Many things which are unwholesome, unholy, unattractive, not good, impure. So how do we use God's gift of sight to each one of us to see past all that, to see God's goodness at work, to see beauty in God's creation, so that our mind and soul are lifted up to Him, and that we can offer Him a prayer of thanksgiving and glory in saying, "Wow, look, the beautiful colors that you have arranged for us for our enjoyment." Cultivate virtue that way. How do you cultivate virtue through your eyes? Do you maintain custody of the eyes in a time of temptation? How do we do that? Very practical. How do we render God for His house? Our eyes, sight, a gift from Him. How do we give that back to Him? Thank you very much. And as you may sun shining through the stained glass right now, perhaps the Lord, the Holy Spirit, is in my Practical began